Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and boy, today have we got a treat for you. We had the absolute pleasure of chatting to Peredur Ap Gwynedd, guitarist for the mighty Pendulum. Perry took time just before their insane show at Glasgow's OVO Hydro Arena to talk about his stunning guitars, effects, amps, and everything in between that give Pendulum that massive sound live, that massive sound we all know and love. It's so all-encompassing, it's magnificent. He's such an awesome dude too. I hope you have as much fun watching this as we did shooting it. That's enough chat, let's get into it. Very much. Thank you so much for joining me here today.
No worries, yes.
It's been an absolute pleasure.
Thank you for coming along.
How's the tour been so far? Last day tonight.
Oh, it's been amazing, yeah. It's only been a week and a half, just a UK tour, but it's been...
You crammed a lot in that week and a half.
Yeah, it's our first proper UK tour in 14 years.
That's so insane.
We've done gigs and festivals and stuff, but it's our proper tour.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully we can get some pictures on the screen now of how insane the O2 looked in London.
Oh, mate.
And Birmingham was sold out. It was incredible.
Oh, God,
and I can't wait for tonight in Glasgow, man. It's going to be great.
Yeah, it's been really good. We've been really, really happy with the fact that people still like us, which is really cool.
Hell yeah, it's impossible not to like. You guys are incredible. You've always been incredible, and tonight's going to be incredible.
Oh, hope so.
Speaking of incredible,
yeah,
can we check out the star of the show, in my humble guitarist's opinion, and that is your wonderful gold PRS that you're rocking.
The gold one? It's weird, nobody ever speaks about this. Here it is.
It's one of the coolest guitars you will ever see.
So, everything.
What is it?
Everything on it. It's basically, this is an SE model.
Yeah.
This is an SE Custom 24 Floyd, obviously.
You've been with PRS for years.
Yeah.
So, if you have the option to, you could play as many Custom 24s as you want.
Yes.
But you're quite enamored by an SE model, aren't you?
Well, I've had SEs as well, and they're just as good as the American models.
100%, yeah.
Although the American models are a little bit more refined.
Yes.
My main guitar previous to this was an American Custom 24, mm-hmm. and it's still one of the best guitars I've ever played.
Yeah.
But that was with me until Friday. That's at home now.
Okay.
But still, this is just an amazing guitar. So.
So this is number one.
Yeah.
I mean, why wouldn't it be number one?
Yeah. Look at it.
Very shiny gold.
So I basically changed everything. All the metal bits that were chrome, mm-hmm. I swapped them over to gold. So it's a gold. That's a Goto.
Yeah.
Floyd.
I'm going to talk to you about this in a second. So I'm curious why you're using the Goto and stuff. And
the only reason.
Because you've got a Graphtech on your backup, I believe, as
well. Yeah, but the only reason I use that was the only one that was available at the time.
Oh, really?
There's no reason, yeah.
Oh, because I've got a couple of Gotos on some old Kramers and stuff.
Okay.
And I think they do play slightly different. So I was wondering if you had, like, in your head that you preferred the Goto over the Floyd, because it is a common debate.
I don't mind either.
Yeah.
I just love the Floyd design, and, I mean, it's kind of stiff.
But a bit of flutter on it as well.
Yeah, you can still do the old...
Yeah, man.
Still do that with it.
Little nerdy thing as well. It's the Titan grub screw bar as opposed to the thing. Is that a deliberate thing for yourself? Or?
No, it's just what
came.
Yeah. So I'm not particularly fussy about it, and it just plays great. If it did play badly, I would have taken it off.
You'd switch it around,
of course. But this is great. So I've got gold tips, gold knobs, gold machine heads, gold strap blocks, just kind of everything's gold in it, and that's a Sustainiac.
Yep.
The reason I use a Sustainiac is we don't use amps on stage anymore. And so to get feedback, it's way easier to get it.
They're the best things in the world, yeah.
They're amazing. They're so cool.
People who watched the channel previously might know that I might love the Sustainiacs as well and how they work. There's a whole video on the channel about how Sustainiacs works. If you're unsure, I'll link that down below. But it's the most fun you can have without shredding. It's great.
So, you know, you've got the normal sustain, then you've got the octave, then you've got the higher harmonic, so you can get different
it's
levels
so cool.
of feedback.
And wrapped as well. Oh, yeah. Gold as well.
So I had this idea last summer. Well, I've had it for a while. I wanted a gold guitar because I wanted to do silly things with it.
Of course, yeah. Well, guitarists are tacky in a way. I like to show off.
Absolutely. So I got this done, and the secret is to it, it's not solid gold.
Oh, really?
It's not the solid gold guitar.
Oh, I thought you got this from Goldsmiths. No, I thought this was a...
No, it's actually vinyl wrap.
That's amazing. So, that's so cool.
My luthier friend, who... His previous job was a car mechanic, and he used to wrap cars for a living. So when I told him about this, he went, I can do that.
That's perfect. It's hard wiring as well.
Yeah. Yeah, it's amazing. So headstock's done, the body's done, and it just looks great on stage. I even got...
The gold strap.
Even bought a gold strap for it.
That's so cool.
Because, you know, you have to, really.
Yeah, you totally have to. I will say it's great watching someone pioneer the Floyd Rose equipped PRS. Because
yeah.
you don't often see it, but yeah. they do so many Floyd Rose equipped guitars, and yeah. they're fantastic things.
I mean, I was reticent about playing PRS to start with because of the non-locking trem, but once they started the locking yeah. trem, I thought, yeah, because I do give it some welly.
Yeah, yeah.
But having played a few PRS guitars without the locking trem, yeah. they stay in tune anyway.
They are fantastic. Yeah, their whole trem sounds awesome. Yeah.
And that's the whole reason I play them, guitars, is because of the tuning consistency.
Yeah.
Yes, they're amazing guitars, and they sound great. Everybody knows yeah. that. But it's the tuning consistency that's really important.
Yeah. You know,
I've played so many other guitars, mm-hmm. and the, you know, one song in, the G string goes out, yeah. or whatever, you know. So,
that's but like, this Pendulum is such an intense stage show, yeah. and you play so, it's not exactly a Steely Dan concert, yeah. is it? Like, you need that consistency, and it's obviously PRS are delivering.
Absolutely, yeah. And yeah, they're just my favourite guitars, and they just work. And so.
Bridge pickup wise, is that stock, or is it just stock with a cover?
Yeah, and he just put a cover on it.
Nice.
And. So gold,
is it US
obviously.
PRS? USA PRS, or is it the SE pickup?
This is the SE.
It's the SE pickup?
Yeah.
Wow.
The SE stock ones are great as well. Yeah. The HFS, I think they're called.
Amazing.
But yeah, but I just love them. I absolutely love them.
I've noticed on the back of a headstock as well, you're rocking the little polytune clip.
Oh,
thing.
Yeah.
That's an interesting little.
So, as we talk about later, we don't use amps on stage.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't use pedals on stage. Everything's automated. So. Obviously, I don't have a pedal board, so how do I tune
yeah.
the guitar? So, oh no, so.
Because of the nature of guitars, they can slip. Even though they're perfect guitars, yeah, they can slip with different humidities yeah, and heats and yeah. stuff.
Just in case. Usually, as it gets hotter, it goes slightly flat. Now, mm-hmm. just because of physics and
yeah,
because
of
the string. So I've got a TC polytune glued to the back of the headstock.
Steve Vai does the same thing.
Does he really? Yeah. So it's the best way to do it. So it's... So
they're cracking up tuners, aren't they?
Instead of you know, stick them on the top, yeah. top of the head, there's not much room for it anyway. We just glued it and it works perfectly. So
that's fantastic.
There you go.
So this is number one.
Yeah.
Is this the stay for the entire show?
Yeah. More or less.
Unless something happens, you're going to use this. Because we'll talk about these and show them off in a second. But
I've never broken the string on stage with Pendulum yeah. ever.
Wow.
I use British Steels, broke with sound British Steels, and they just work. I've never ever snapped one. So.
Consistency is key yeah. for your kind of stage
Absolutely,
show and
yeah.
your whole ethos is just consistency yeah. and tone.
So the rotor sounds have always worked for me, so I've been really lucky with that. But they're just solid. And
amazing. So this is number one. Can we yeah. have a little check out of the backups and stuff?
Just yeah, so some of the songs, there's an acoustic, are there acoustic parts? Let me just, this one. Yeah. So I use this, which is the PRS Custom 24, P24.
Mm-hmm.
It's got a piezo output as well.
Yeah.
So this bridge pickup, this bridge's got
piezo saddles.
Piezo saddles on it, and it sounds great.
PRS makes some of the best piezos on the entire planet.
Oh mate,
they're beautiful
it's
things.
Ridiculous.
Yeah. Before you rocked up, because you Barry just got off a flight and came straight here. We were chatting to you a second earlier and whatnot, and some of the guys were saying the first time you played through that, through yeah. your little TC thing, which we'll talk about in a second,
yeah.
they thought you were miming.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it sounded like an acoustic guitar, and it was an electric guitar, obviously, but no, it's just how good the piezo is.
It sounds more or less exactly like a plugged-in acoustic,
yeah.
you know, or even better, it sounds quite mic'd up as well, so mm-hmm. it's a really good system. However, those boffins in Baltimore.
Yeah.
In Maryland, make them. It's just fantastic. You know?
Are you not tempted to Floyd Rose an acoustic piezo with a Sustainiac and do that whole kind of crazy thing?
No, I've thought about it,
yeah.
but and I've got the stuff at home to do it.
Yeah.
But it just means gouging out too much wood.
Gouging out too much wood, so many batteries,
yeah, yeah.
more things to go wrong, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. But this is such. This sounds so good anyway. And I had the Floyd. The Ghost system, the LR63, I think it's called. I had those on some old guitars. They're all right, but it didn't quite cut it. But
yeah.
the acoustic sound on this is just ridiculous.
Yeah, the wonderful things. And what a stunning guitar.
Yes, it's amazing. Yeah, and this is one of the American ones as well. A bit scratched up in the back.
Hell yeah, man. It's supposed to be.
This has been used. Yeah, I've been using this for a while now, so yeah.
Is that a Heiser Camp strap as well?
Yeah, it's yeah. Heiser Camp, yeah.
Good lads, the guys at Heiser Camp.
Yeah, lovely guys, Heiser Camp. Yeah. It's a beautiful
One more, again, that I'm such a guitar nerd. I know you are to an extent as well. Yeah. I can see on the backup, you've got the back plate off.
Yes.
When it comes to, are those noiseless springs on the back? Or do you change the blocks at all? Or?
I haven't changed anything apart from the springs. I did change them because apparently they're noiseless. Because I did use this as a number one for a while.
Yeah.
So this is the
I thought up. The gold one was this.
So basically this is exactly the same guitar, but a few years older. It's the SE, Custom 24 Floyd, with the Sustainiac in it again.
Yeah.
But this one hasn't been wrapped.
Yeah.
So, but it's exactly the same as that. But, and I think, yeah, these are not.
Noises, yeah. But you don't put a big block, brass block or anything, it's just straight up from the factory.
Yeah. It's just, yeah. But I changed the Floyd on this as well because it's gold. Yeah. So all the bits in this are gold as well.
If you can, why don't you?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, amazing. Gold and purple, and it just looks great. Yeah.
So those are the axes. Let's work our way down, mate. So strings and picks.
Strings.
You mentioned the roto sounds before.
Yeah. So I've been using roto sound British Steels for years.
Yeah.
They just work. Because I've got a nickel allergy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
So when I play a fresh set of nickel strings, mm-hmm. it just hurts my fingers. So I'm such a wuss. But these are perfect.
Yeah.
And they're a lot brighter than nickel strings as well. Mm-hmm. So.
And I suppose that helps as well with the amount of stuff going on with Pendulum Live. It's nice to have a bit more of a bite, I guess.
Yeah.
And that might help
Absolutely.
With that. Yeah.
Yeah. But, and. I don't know why, but they keep fresh for longer.
Yeah.
That
bite. I've heard that in the past as well. Yeah.
Because they're stainless steel and there's no coating on them, so these just work. And I couldn't use anything else.
11s, yeah.
Yeah. But it's tuned down a semitone, so.
Okay. E flat with.
Yeah. 11, so, yeah. I'm not an extremely hard man. So there is tuned down. So, yeah. But and whatever the scale length of these are 25, I think. Mm-hmm. So and it just works perfectly for. The tension wiser and Tortex 73s. I've been using these for years as well, and the reason I use these was when I was a kid, whenever it's a snap string, it always when I'd be playing heavier picks, I thought, you know what, I'm gonna try something lighter.
Yeah,
so I found the perfect the harmony between pick and string.
That's amazing. Live about on a table and this kind of ratio between them. Yeah,
so I grew up in the countryside and there wasn't but the closest music shop was 25 miles away, so if I did break a string, I'd be,
I was exactly the same growing up, I totally feel your pain.
So so I thought, right, how am I going to sort this? So, yellow 73s, and, well, it was 10s back then, because I had a Strat back when I was a kid, so, and I've always used it, and I can't really play any of the picks.
Reckon? Yeah, again, like, consistency, it's like what you like,
I'm really awful with other picks, it's like, especially the heavy ones, but, these got enough flex in them, because I do hit the guitar really hard.
Yeah.
Anything harder will break straight.
Yeah, so. It is great. So many guitar players just use either the greens or yellow.
Yeah.
Dunlops.
Yeah.
I think they've got some kind of special magic pick of destiny. Nope.
Yeah.
Just straight up yellow. The green.
At home, when I in my studio at home, when I'm doing acoustic, I use the orange ones, the 63s.
The thinner ones.
That's what we use for strumming. So and these are more for the picky bits, but acoustic strums, the orange Tortex. Love them.
Awesome, man.
Yeah.
So from the guitars, I know you've just got a new wireless setup as well.
Oh, it's brilliant. Yeah. This is the rack system for me and Gareth, the bass player. So this is Gareth's world here, and it's my world down here. So we're using the Audio Technica 5000 series.
Fantastic things.
And they're amazing. Best wireless system I've ever used.
Yeah, talking to your tech before, there's so much Wi-Fi frequencies and Bluetooth cutting about the stage. This is what you need for this kind of show.
It's amazing how the technology that they do use, because everything's computer-based as well. It's all done on the laptop. You know, there's an app for it, and you can pick and choose your frequencies.
Yeah.
It's so much more complicated than what it was, but it works.
Yeah, exactly.
So there's no dropouts at all. You know, I know a lot of people still have big problems with dropouts, in big gigs like this.
People are used to what they're used to.
Yeah, absolutely.
And like they don't want to kind of upgrade and stuff, but you have to for this kind of thing, especially for this kind of show.
But it's amazing, and they sound great as well. And we're very, very pleased with them. You know,
awesome.
So
speaking of modern tech with that, you are rocking Helix, and you have rocked Helix for a while.
I haven't switched a guitar amp on since New Year's Eve 2018.
Because you used to be, was it Hughes and Kettner? I remember seeing like walls of Hughes and Kettner behind you, but obviously times have changed a lot since back in the day, and you're a big modeler guy now.
Yeah, the last show pre-Helix was, or I did use a Helix as well. I still used the Hughes and Kettner with a Helix.
Right.
So the Hughes and Kettner was Grandmeister, and that would be a mono signal. Because we played big gigs. You know, and it's only one guitarist, we need a bit of a spread. If it was just stereo, it'd sound a bit weak.
Yeah.
So we have a mono signal bang in the middle.
I remember you telling me about this, and that's such a great concept to have like that.
So it's kind of a wet, dry, wet. So a mono signal bang in the middle, and then a stereo.
Yeah. So everyone's getting the full effect.
So you can be where. So the stage is there. You can be there, 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 and you still get a fat guitar sound because you're hearing two all the time. Whereas if the mono signal wasn't there, it'll be either left, a little bit right,
and exactly. Like, you'd be getting ping pongs and half of modulation sounds.
And it's so much more punch with the mono signal down the middle. And the Hughes Kettner was great there because it was light, it was only 8 kilos.
Yeah.
But we started doing fly gigs and we couldn't take a lot of the rig with us, so we decided, let's just try the Helix on its own. Mm-hmm. So instead of the Hughes and Kettner, we still needing the models, the mono signal. So that's what we've got here is a HX Storm.
So that's running the mono down the middle?
Yeah.
And the big Helix is running either side?
Yeah, so that's running one of the effects loops of that.
Oh,
so
cool.
It goes mono, and then that is a stereo.
Yeah.
And it's stereofied with, it's just a dual delay. And one side is, delayed by 25 milliseconds.
Right.
So it just gives a spread.
Yeah.
So, and it just works like that. And
the way you run the stereo setup, are you running, like, say, two separate amps either side, or is it the same amp and stuff?
Same amp.
Yeah.
So, same amp, stereofied, and with a different amp in the middle. So, the HX Stomp amp, the mono amp, is always different to the stereo amp.
Ah, interesting.
So it's like running two stereo amps that are the same with another amp in the middle.
Yeah. People say sometimes it's not as fun talking about modelers than it is real amps.
Yeah.
These can do so much, and you can have so much fun and play with stuff.
Oh, it's amazing.
Let's get into the signal chain within Helix.
Yeah.
How do you set up a signal chain? Like, if you were to start a fresh signal chain, what's your go-to amplifiers for the Pendulum stuff, and how do you set it up?
I start off with usually a compressor.
Right.
I just love compressed sounds, especially clean. So there's usually a red squeeze, whatever it's called, first in line, and that's always used for the clean sound, and sometimes for solo sounds as well. And then there's usually the dual rectifier for the stereo, or there's the archetype lead for the stereo.
Mm-hmm.
I mix and match, you know.
Yeah.
But and it's kind of the same for the, I think it might be an angle. Model for
the mono.
Yeah, I think it's an angle, but it chops and changes every song, so every song's kind of sounds slightly different.
Okay.
So then.
So you don't stick with a sound and change it slightly song to song. You change the entire setup pretty much song to song.
Not on purpose, but you know, if I need a little bit, say if we've got a new song, I'll start a new. Preset up from scratch, and I'll use that sounds good, and then mess about with it. So there's no real method to the madness, but you know, it kind of works.
It works a treat. It doesn't kind of work. It works a treat. It sounds fantastic.
And then from the amp, then sometimes I use a clean amp head and a distorted amp head through the same. Cab.
Okay, to get some clarity in the.
Yes, just.
Oh, wow.
So I flip between those two for clean and.
It's amazing what technology can do.
Yeah, no, yeah.
It's fantastic. Yeah. It's so cool.
And then that usually runs into. I just use the simple delay in that for some stereo delay. And then that runs into the dual delay to stereofy it. That's the other way around. The dual delay to stereofy it, then into the. Big delay sound, and then right at the very end, I use there's a model called the LA Comp, which is the LA2 compressor, and I use that in stereo, and it just makes it sound really good at the end. It's like if you're recording with an amp in the studio, the last thing in the chain, there's a compressor on before it hits the hits the tape, you know, hits the desk. So and I've done exactly the same thing. It just makes it sound really good. So I call it the ultra awesomizer.
The ultra amazing.
It just makes clean sounds and distorted sounds sound bright
pop.
And
that's on the mono signal as well as a stereo signal.
Yeah.
Are you using impulse responses, or is it straight up just the stuff that comes with Helix?
Stock.
See, I always say that I love messing with impulse responses, as probably you do as well, but the stuff that comes with Helix is just, they wouldn't put it in if it wasn't great from the factory.
So we've got a new bunch of cabs now that are, they are impulse responses, and you can mess with them. You can take The microphone and put it wherever you want, in you know,
exactly.
the changer wherever you
exactly.
want. But you know, I've got a load of impulse sponsors at home, and yeah, once you get to number like 98, you've forgotten what the other 97 sounded like.
Of course,
it was just like,
of course.
And yeah, it's yeah, and it's very dull.
It is interesting seeing an SY300 as well. Yeah. Is that running your rig as well?
Yeah.
What's that guy for?
A lot of some of the sounds in the set. You see me playing, and I said, that doesn't sound like a guitar, that sounds like a synthesizer, yeah. because it's me playing kind of synthesizer.
Yeah, welcome to the world of Boss synthesizers.
Yeah, yeah.
There's so many awesome guitar synths.
Now, I've had this for quite a while now.
Is that running into a loop in the Helix, or is that a separate signal completely?
That goes
or?
In stereo loop in the Helix. So, yeah. Oh, one thing I forgot to say, the first thing that the guitar hits in the first loop is a HX1.
So, oh, yeah. The new little
Line 6. I use that at the moment solely for pitch shifting.
Oh, cool. So, the pitch shift is fantastic in that. Yeah. It's an amazing thing.
So the polycapo. So I don't have to... Back in the day, 14 years ago, I took about 8 guitars out with me, you know, and I only use 2. I've got 3 here, but I only use 2. I could only easily take 2 out, but we used... instead of tuning down, say, 5 semitones, I just do it in that, I just go, whoop, and it sounds great. You
exactly.
know? So it's just
it sounds fun for me and mortals taking 8 guitars out on tour.
Yeah.
I'm guessing when you do it as a lifestyle and a job, it's just a pain, and it's easier to do it all.
Yeah, absolutely,
technology
based. It's so much easier, you know, even for a rig this big.
Yeah.
You know, it's just way easier to do it like that. You know.
So that's the electric guitar cover, all your effects, your amplifiers, everything's inbuilt to Helix. For the piezo sound you mentioned before on the Custom 24, what are you rocking for that?
I use a TC Electronic body res.
Cracking thing.
It's ridiculous.
They've been out for so many years and they haven't really changed it because it's perfect from the get-go.
So basically, that's what it does. You know when you DI an acoustic sound, it sounds plasticky.
Mm-hmm.
Any guitar, you know, the most expensive acoustic guitar, if you have a piezo pickup in it, it will sound plasticky. Mm-hmm. You stick it into this pedal and it sounds like it's mic'd up.
Yeah.
So
it gives it all the life and the resonance and the sizzle that you want.
Absolutely. And it's just beautiful. And I've been using it for years. And
do you rock that into any kind of Helix as well, or is that just straight out into...
That goes into the auxiliary input of the Helix. So that's all that's coming out of the Helix is a stereo out.
Yeah.
So, and everything's mixed in and it goes to front of house as is. So front of house has got left and right. And electric and acoustic is all mixed into that.
Yeah.
So
it's incredibly clever what you can do these days.
Yeah, and it's so much simplicity is the thing as well. You know, it's getting we've simplified our setup so much over the last few years, and it just works better like that.
Yeah.
You know, amazing. Less things to go wrong.
Of course.
You know, you've got left and right, and that's all you got for me. And and same with Gareth, the bass player, left and right, and it's like. That's all it is.
Hell yeah, man.
Yeah.
So that side of the stage, to end this, let's go check out your pedal board.
Okay.
Let's do it. So your pedal board, or lack thereof.
We don't have it.
These days, with the way Pendulum run their show, everything's via MIDI and...
Yes, everything's automated. We've got all the Helix parts, all the program changes, the wah-wah, everything, the expression pedals, is all done via MIDI, via Ableton.
Yeah.
So it's all run on Ableton. So about a year ago, we recorded all my my changes into Ableton.
Oh, so you actually did it real time?
Yeah, we did it in real time.
Oh, brilliant.
So every single one of the songs, we just did one run through and went bang, bang, bang. So all the foot switches, I use the onboard wah-wah as well, which is, it's an amazing wah-wah, I just love it. So everything was recorded into Ableton.
Is there a part of you which kind of misses the live action presence?
No, not at all. It's so much easier. You can like concentrate on like doing your hair
in the mirror guitar. Yeah, you do your hair.
No, but I thought I would miss it, but I don't at all.
Yeah,
it's just a lot easier.
Again, consistency and simplicity is what you strive for, because there's so much going on. Like I was saying, it's not exactly like AC/DC or Steely Dan, like I was saying before. It is.
Yeah.
There's so much going on, so you need that to make sure everything's consistently mint.
Yeah. So this is where I start off the show. I spend half the time up here on this riser, and the rest of the time I'm down, going back and forth, being an idiot in the front.
Amazing.
And then, but there is only one. There is one foot switch.
Right.
And that's here, the Whirlwind multi-selector. Mm-hmm. So that switches the guitars.
Yeah, just between the wireless packs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So well, my guitars are down here. Obviously, my rig's over on the other side, but my guitars are down here.
Mm-hmm.
So I swap guitars here, and
Then Kit, the other tech, who also doubles up as a drum tech, he does the switching for me. So I've got a little switch, but I don't do any switching.
Kick ass. But like I was saying before, the goal thing, the goal of the PRS as much as you can, unless something happens in the acoustic when it needs most.
Absolutely, yeah. So everything's there, but I've never broken a string, so touch wood.
Amazing.
I never need it.
Well, Curry, I think that's everything. Thank you so much for your time. It's been an absolute pleasure chatting to you.
It's been an honour, mate.
Love Pendulum, love what you do, and I can't bloody wait to see you tonight.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
It's going to be great.
I want to see you down the mosh pit, yeah?
I'll be right there. I'll have a sign, a gold sign, shining back at you.
Brilliant.
Thank you so much, mate. Cheers, guys. Thank you.